Hello dear students, I am assistant professor Rushali Ahil, and in the last session of microbiology part first, we have already started with the biomolecules in which we are learning about the lipids. We have already seen that lipids may be regarded as organic substances which are insoluble in water but soluble in different types of organic solvents like alcohols, ethers, etc. Now in these we were studying the classification of lipids, and we have already seen that lipids are broadly classified into three types: simple lipids, complex lipids, and derived lipids, in which we have already studied the first type, which is simple lipids. In this session, we are going to learn about the second type of lipid, which includes compound lipids or complex lipid. Now, compound lipids or the complex lipids are the esters of fatty acids with alcohols containing additional groups. Now, they are fatty acids esterified with alcohols, and in addition, they contain other groups like phosphate, nitrogen bases, carbohydrates, proteins, etc. And depending on these extra groups, the compound lipids can be further divided into various subclasses like phospholipid containing phosphoric acids, non-phosphorylated lipids, glycolipids, lipoproteins, and other complex lipids. That all these different subclassified lipids we will study one by one in detail. The first division depending on the phosphate group is our phosphate lipid or phospholipids. Now, a phospholipid, it is a lipid containing phosphoric acid and frequently a nitrogen base. It generally contains phosphoric acid and nitrogen bases, as well as in addition to these both groups, it also contains alcohol and fatty acid. So a phospholipid is a amphiphatic molecule which is made up of four components, which includes fatty acid, phosphate, alcohol, and glycerol or spingosins. Now, the spingosins is a type of lipid and these phospholipids are also called as phosphatids, which generally contains the phosphorus atom. As the phosphorus atom is present in these lipids, so they may be known as phosphatids. And these phospholipids are very important in various organisms, as it provides a structural component to the cell membrane, including those of the cell organelles. Now we have already studied the cell structure of various organisms, and in our previous sessions we have seen the cell membrane of the bacteria, and we have studied both the types, gram negative cell membrane as well as cell membrane of gram positive bacteria, in which we have studied that the cell membrane of gram positive bacteria contains phospholipid at the A thick layer of phospholipid is present, which provides a various functions to the cell membrane of the gram-positive bacteria. As well as phospholipids are of different kinds, but all of them contains a glycerol residue to which they are attached with the help of ester linkage. With the help of ester bond, the glycerol is attached to the phospholipid. And two long chain fatty acid and a phosphorylated components. Sometimes phospholipid grouped under polar lipids because they are radially soluble in polar solvents such as ethanol. In ethanol, the phospholipids are soluble, and these phospholipids can be broken down to their residue with the help of different enzymes like enzyme phosphatidase. The enzyme phosphatidase can break the bonds present inside the phospholipid. This was about the first type of compound lipid, which is phospholipid. The second one is glycolipids. Now, the glycolipids are the molecule generally contains both carbohydrates and lipid component. As well as the lipid contains a fatty acid, carbohydrate and nitrogen base group. The third group which is present in the glycolipid is carbohydrate and nitrogen bases. Now, the alcohol is spingosine. Hence, they are also known as glycospingolipids. These glycolipids are also known as glycospingolipids. The glycerol and phosphate are absent in the glycolipids. As we have seen in the phosphate or the phospholipid, there are different forms of phospholipids. But in all the forms of phospholipid, glycerin was present or the glycerol group was present. But in the glycolipids, the phosphate as well as glycerol is absent. For example, cerebrosides or gangliosides are the example of glycolipids which does not contains phospholipids or glycerol group. This is the membrane structure which contains the glycolipids. Then there are different types of glycolipids like cerebrosides, which we have already seen in the example. Then gangliosides, sulfoglycospingosides. These were the some of the examples of glycolipids. Now, what are the functions of glycolipids? The glycolipids are essential part of the cell membrane. As we have seen the structure of cell membrane, here you can see in the membrane structure, the glycolipids is a layer of lipid membrane is generally present. Whenever we are seeing the cell wall of gram-negative bacteria, in the cell wall of gram-negative bacteria, a thin layer of lipid is present, which provides a protection to the inner components of the bacteria. So, the glycolipids are the essential part of the cell membrane, as well as it is used or it helps in the determination of the blood group of an individual. In the detection of the blood group type of an individual, the glycolipids are helpful. Then, glycolipids acts as a receptor at the surface of the red blood cell. On the surface of the red blood cell, as a receptor, this glycolipid plays an important role. In some of the viruses, bacteria, use of glycolipid on their cell surface as a receptor. This helps the immune system to destroy and clear the pathogen from the body. As these glycolipids are present on the red blood cell, this helps to activate the immune system of an individual. If our immune system gets activated, the removal of these pathogens gets easier, which prevents our body from getting attracted to the various infections. So, this was all about the second type of lipid, which is also known as compound or complex lipid. In the next session, we will study about the third type of lipid, which is known as derived lipid. Thank you.